'Tis the season of Festivalt in Stormreach.
Good morning. Welcome to another exciting episode of DDO Wiki Talk with your host, Technical 13. You can see a new little icon in the, that would be the left-hand side of the screen down on the bottom corner next to my CPU temperature there. It'll actually show up inside of my cam once I get rid of the splash screens. That is an indicator of who is speaking in the DDO stream Discord channel. I've decided that I'm going to start trying to remember to get into Discord so that anybody that wants to chat with me on stream may do so. So, let's hop over to the wiki. And here we are. How is everybody this morning? I hope everybody is well. Feel free to say hello and good morning. So, at the beginning of the stream, the reason I'm like 5 minutes late, even though I was all ready to go, is I started up my Turbine Point Code giveaway application that I created for the stream here, and realized that I need to update that. It's no longer Turbine Points. So, here's the application. Let's do a little bit of modification. It's no longer a TP code giveaway. Let's make it DDO code giveaway. And let's change today's prize from being a default of 500 TP to 500 DP. All right, let's see here. What else can I do? I don't remember what else I referred to as turbine points. The name of the form, I need to update that. I'm gonna make it form DDO code giveaway. Prize. So that all looks good. You can see a stats button there. I have not yet enabled that. It's another part of the thing that I haven't gotten to yet. Make sure I update this here. Right here. Actually, rules of the code here. Default prizes, set those back to the new updates. Maybe I should change it to SSG. But for now, meh. We'll do this. Alright, save all. And there we go. Hopefully there's no more DDO form references to the old form name. All right, let's start up the application. Drag this out here in the middle. I'll have to do a recapture of it for the stream. Today's prize will be 500 DDO points for 25 viewers. Who do we have in chat this morning? I'm going to save this one as episode 49. There we go. Bring that down. There we go, say hi in chat. We can shrink this. And here's our beautiful wiki. Before we get into that too much, let me go like this real quick. Do some hosting.
Well met. Well met. Well met.
Woohoo! Here's the hosting train. The shoe host train coming in.
Well met.
Bring the wiki back up. Let's have a look here. Recent changes. Let's see, we were here last week. Let's see what's happened in a week. December 20th. I talk welcome. Update 32 patch 2 came out. Had to do a little bit of client updating this morning for that. I made a new page for a greater bracelet of friends on December 21st. Turbine staff got moved to Standing Stone Games staff, and the user staff template got updated to go from Turbine to Standing Stone Games. One of our users moved free-to-play Turbine Point walkthrough to free-to-play DDO Point walkthrough with some assistance, requested assistance. Had a few spam bots recently. And other than that, looks like not a lot has happened over the Christmas week slash weekend. Legendary Hound of Zoriette has had a random IP repeatedly change it. Trying to change it to free to play, which I don't remember if it is or is not, but I had believed that the developers told me it was part of the Veil Pack, and part of the Veil Pack means that it is not free to play. So I'd need somebody to verify that it's not part of the Veil Pack in order for that to be marked as such, which I will probably do tonight when I have a little bit of free time. Zorian Cypher. Special pages, let's have a look here. We have three double redirects, let's clean those right up. That's a piece of low-hanging fruit. Free-to-play TP walkthrough, free-to-play turbine point walkthrough, free-to-play DDO point walkthrough. Fix this redirect. Turbine point to DDO point, TP to turbine point to DDO point. Fixed, 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 everything's fixed. Reload the page. All done. I love low-hanging fruit. If I remember correctly, we were at 10 wanted categories last week, so let's take a look and see what's new here. Summon adventuring party clicky items. Weapons ooze damage effect. The armor piercing. Monsters in the Sharn Syndicate I can do. The effect items I'm going to leave alone for now. Terminal Delirium I can do. Adventuring Party I can do. Hey, Merry Christmas, Zarag! Let's add you as the first viewer. Some odd noises in my headset, so I'm gonna plug it in and see if that helps any. Indeed. Actually, let's do this. Good morning, Antidote. I do have a notification in LFMs on a couple servers this morning. I think I'm on Caneth and Argo, maybe? Alright, so these are going to be armor-piercing items. Let's add... antidote. You're number two on our list this morning. Oh, right, I should do this too. Good morning, Amref. Here, I'll do those ones as well. Let's do those as well. I'm going to call them weapons effect items. Morning, El Pair. I would like to think it's just your browser, but we can take a look at it as soon as I'm done with this section. Thank you. Good morning. How are you enjoying the game? Just that I'm giving away 500 turbine point code at 25 euros. Alright, so far Ruin Arm looks good to me. They're all sorted by damage type. Cold, acid, electrical, light, fire, force, and then random damages. And then at the top, you have your arrows here, so you can sort them by level. Level 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. Template errors. Must be in your browser. I can look and see if there's anything. Well, I don't know. I don't even know if that would show up. Let me check something real quick. There's nothing here that would show it, but let's see here. It's a DPL, so I would have to go view page source to get the actual code for that. Let's see here. Page source. You need to update your browser. So depending on your browser, it's either Control-Shift-R or some combination of Control-Shift-R or F5. Yeah, there's nothing there. That's what I'm looking for right there. Usually if there's template errors, you'll see that post-expand include size, this number is very close to this number, or larger than that number, and that's why it fails. But there's nothing here for that. December 17th, I updated the template here to use to get rid of named runearm.ptbl. So there should be no more ptbl at all in there. So, what you need to do is bypass your cache. So, on Firefox, it's either hold shift while clicking reload or press Control F5 or Control R, Command R on a Mac. On Google Chrome, it's Control Shift R. On Internet Explorer, it's Control F5. On Conqueror, it's F5 itself. In Opera, you need to go into Tools Preferences to clear the cache. And more details here on depending on which browser. And then the other thing that you can do is at the bottom of the page, category rune arms. You'll see the above was automatically compiled via DPL whenever. Hit this link right here to refresh it, and that will update the table for you. It will take a while for it to reload. It's rebuilding it all, but that'll reset that. All right, so weapons, effect items. Those I'm going to leave alone for now. Good morning, Mo. Ow. All right, so which version has the 6%? Which version has the 9%? Level 15 must be 12. Five and 10. Need to update that. Actually, it's level 15 one in there too. Let's go through all of these. Weapons. Effect. Slashing. Two. Weapons effect. Random DDO user. And Quizilla. That's armor piercing amount. Okay, so weapon effect, number, amount. There we go, that's what I want right there. No picture, okay. Picture either. Two, five. Type. Critical. So it's this. Number, then type. Oh, and bleed's a little bit different, so we'll have to make adjustments for that. Ah, okay, so yep, that's a note there for that one. I'll have to fix that one. That's just a bad connection. So we got, let's see here. Can touch 420. El Rogu. We are editing DDO Wiki. I already have Ansel Helm. It won't let me add it again. Okay, so weapon effect. It does look complicated, although it's not as complicated as it looks. Yes, the forum can be complicated to get things to look the way that you want. Cambosarlona. Hey, we're halfway there. Being able to give away a 500-point code. Okay. So. Slashing, slashing, slashing. Already got the slashing there. Already got the slashing there. Let's get the bleed. 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 People want to know how to do maps, huh? I don't actually do most of the maps. I'm not sure how most of them are made, although I can probably wing it when need be. All right. I always like to do a show preview. Slashing, bleed, critical slashing. So the only thing I need to do here is update the bleed to actually be D8 in the template. So let's go down here to weapon effect. Number of dice. Well, most of the update 34 Linania stuff is already up. I went through and did that the night it came out. All right, so what I want to do here is decides. And I want to define it with a switch. With the default being six sides. And it's going to be if type, which is number two. If it's bleed, then it has eight sides. I want to take that as lowercase. And we're going to do a coffee refill. About 10 minutes early today, but we're going to do a coffee refill and a bathroom break, and I will be right back. And we're back. Coffee's refilled. Last cup is evacuated. All right, what was I doing? Oh, correct. I remember now. Let's see here. This is going to be a var of D-sides. I want to make an override of that for D. So if somebody sets D equals, it will always be whatever D equals is. So I'm going to override that. Actually, I want to put that outside of the switch here. So it'll always be D, whatever D equals, or 6. Save that. Now I should be able to do a show preview on this, and the bleed should be a D8. And it is. Excellent. So I can get rid of this little comment here. Five D6 critical. D8 bleed, D6 anything else? Excellent. I wonder if there's anything else that's named that uses that weapon something effect. They all need a description image. I'm on the wrong server. Aw, I lost. Alright, so let's do quit. And we're going to reload the game client, and I am going to go to Caneth to a character I created called Shu Annie, which holds all of my anniversary items, and see how many of these I have. I probably have like 5 through 20, which is better than nothing. Let's shrink this real quick. Absolutely, and you can help. We love having new people on the wiki that actually are contributing and building the wiki. Most of our new people are spam bots just putting junk on there, but occasionally we do get a new one that helps. All right, let me hit the Canith real quick. Let's see which ones of these we can make, add some screenshots of. So if I go to the top up here, I have Shoe Annie Anniversary, which was just a bank character I made in one of my 15 slots, being VIP and having expansion packs. Okay, so which one is it? Cookie cutter. Ooh, I might have them all. 25. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 20. I got up to 25. That's good.
Tis the season of festival in Stormreach.
Nothing in the bank. All right, so I can screenshot that. Screenshot that. Screenshot that. Screenshot that. Screenshot that. I don't think I have the 30. I do not. Although I do have some more stuff in the bank I need to pull out for this character. Let's see here. I think I had some peanut butter cookies. No. Must have already taken those. First light. I had a first light. Must be the 25 one. It is. Okay. So there's a 25 first light. All right. So. Let's go back to the other server. Good morning, B Killer S3. Well, we're doing some wiki editing. Let's add you to the drawing. We need 12 more attendees to say hi in chat, and we will do the drawing. Over halfway there. Arganesson, let's go there. Arganesson. Hey, welcome, welcome, welcome. Set your name, I will do so at the end of my stream. Shadow Kai is pretty good. I misspelled Kenneth. I believe it is 24.95. All right, so let's make some description images here. I am really, really lazy about it. When you take crops, make sure they're at least 420 px wide. This is how we make screenshots of images. And it looks like I missed Dirty Dexter. I haven't added him yet. It's only free to copy characters to Lamenia. Transferring has never ever been free, and it has always been available. You just got customer service to do it before. All right, level 20. That's 422, that's fine. Cut. New. Don't save. Paste. File, save as, ping. Click on 25. I can change just the 5 to a 0. Save, close, edit. Level 15. Already have the 15. There's a 10. Here's a level 5. Good morning. So, now we can go down here. That shows up as no pick. Edit, 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 edit. There you go. So open that in a new tab, 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 open that in a new tab. Choose file, documents, Dungeons and Dragons, cookie cutter level 25, open. So for uploading images, make sure that you always select screenshot from Dungeons and Dragons Online, and that you, as a source, you can set either your name as a user, or screenshot taken from Dungeons and Dragons. Since I'm on the DDO Wiki account, our DDO Stream Wiki account here, DDO Stream. Can't see it behind the follower bar up there, but I'm on DDO Stream, so I make sure that I link it back to my account. So there's number 25. The level 20. Nope, that's not the one I want. I want screenshot. Level 15. Level 10. And level 5. Alrighty, so now I should be able to do another show preview here and here, 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 and all the images should show up. So I can see it's a +2 with bleed, critical slashing, slashing, armor piercing, and an empty purple slot. So I want to actually reorganize these. I want to put the bleed on top, and I want to put the critical slashing, and then the slashing. I want this list to match this list. Save. Same thing here. Bleed, critical slashing. /373. /252. /494. /410.4. /512.5. There we go. Cookie cutter 5 through 25 is all done. Although for the 20 and 25, I do want to take a new screenshot because these are red boxed, which means I got red text and you're not meeting the minimum level requirement, which means I just have to send that item through my shared bank to a character that's 30 or whatever to look at it. Reload this page. I can edit this page as well. Cookie cutter, level 5. Weapon effect. Bleed +2. 2. Bleed. Good morning, Migo. Amigo. Is it Migo? How do I get those images off the character? Well, go to your character. You open your inventory. You pick an item. You mouse over it. You press Control-P on your keyboard. Okay. Now you can shrink the client down. And you can open up your... In your My Documents, you can go to a folder called Dungeons & Dragons Online. You wait for it to load, and you take whatever the most recent screenshot is. Yes, it does. You right-click on it, and you click on Edit. And that will take the whole screen into your Paint program. So then you click on Selection, which you can't see behind that, so let me hide that real quick. All right, so up here you have Select. You can click on that. Make sure that it's highlighted. Just pick where you want to start with the mouse. Click and drag to pick the whole box. Control X to cut it out. File. New. No, I don't want to save. We'll open up a new box like this. Control V to paste. And now you have just the item that you want. So now you can go to File, Save As, PNG, give it a name, hit Save, and you have just the piece that you want. Make sure you remember where you save it. Alrighty. So let's go here. We got... Don't forget to add Mego. Tech. 2. Seven more viewers, and we have 35 minutes to go. Now if we reload this, okay, level 5, level 10, level 15, level 25, level 30. Wait, where's the level 20? Ah, 15 over here. Okay. Some changes. Alrighty. Actually want to watch that. Back to special pages. Let's see if there's anything else that showed up in wanted categories. Back down to 7. That's good. Hope everybody had a wonderful Christmas. Weapons 3 effect items, critical 8. I need to take a look at those and see what those are. Returning snowball. Returning snowball, so the same item for both of them. Dante Florenzo. Dante A. Florenzo. Add you to the list there. Need six more. I need to update this one. Got some template stuff out of order there. These are backwards. It's actually 8 cold, 3 cold, 3 humanoid specific. There we go, that's better. That's 3d6, but it shouldn't be. It's a that should be specific human. Specific equals humanoid. There, now it should be 3d10 versus humanoids. Okay, so we get +5, humanoid, frostbite, critical cold, cold, orange, returning, mythic. Good. I did. I actually, for the first Christmas ever, I've had all of my children in one place. So, that was exciting. Weapons effect items. Dragon specific, ooze and undead. Calamel, broccoli, Mournlord. Edit, edit, edit. Make sure I have it set for specific on those. Specific dragon, awesome. They are all correct on that. Broccoli basher. Specific ooze, bludgeon, critical, awesome. Ooze, bludgeon, critical. Specific undead, awesome. I just have messages from Elminster left. Excellent. There should probably be a table. If not, we should work on that. What's the best way to do that? Best way to do that would be to create a gallery on the page for the base item. Absolutely. So, for example, if it was, say, a leather armor, you'd put it on the base page for leather armor. And you could add a new section at the bottom of leather armor. Appearances or something like that. And then in there you could create a gallery and in the gallery you're just going to put the file name, which we're going to have to come up with a naming convention for that. Woohoo! Thanks for the follow, Elysian. And then some kind of indicator of what the skin looks like. Something like that. And then you could add a little description about it if you wanted to. Basically, what you're going to want to do is learn how to make a gallery. Only need five more now. Getting there. Another one? Really? Woohoo! Thanks for the follow, Cambo. So here's the Help Images page. Or actually, episode 2 of DD Wiki Talk, over a year ago now, tells you how to take screenshots and how to prepare and upload them. Quiz and Zara. Quiz and Zarag. They're in there. And then where do I upload my images? Follow the instructions found here on the special upload page. Naming concepts in general, it should match the above rules, except obviously end with the appropriate lowercase extension. The wiki is case sensitive and files can only be renamed by certain editors, so it's important to be careful when typing in a file name. File names on the site do not need to match the name of the file you're actually uploading, so the easiest way to ensure you get it right is to link the file first before it exists on the wiki, then click the red link and the upload prompt will automatically fill in the correct file destination. Permitted file types are PNG, GP, JPG, and GIF. Large file threshold is 300 kilobytes. Maximum file size is 2 megs. We've got 20 minutes left to get 5 more people in here. Most desired file type usage, PNG for small and JPEG for large ones. We normally ignore the 300 kilobyte recommendation. Just try to keep it within reason. No externally hosted images, although you can use them on talk pages for quick posts. File naming. You have a certain specific naming set. Page name.png. So carnifex.png for Carnifex. And then for worn action shots, it's whatever it is shown.jpg. Do not crop the item border. So there's all kinds of stuff on the help images page. It tells you how to link images to the article. Different things for that, and so one of the things not on here is how to do galleries. So in order to do galleries, you'll need to go to either the Wikipedia documentation on it. Galleries. Tells you how to do it. So it's gallery, whatever it is, and then whatever the caption is. MW help image. So for galleries, you're going to want to get the images here. That gives you, tells you how to do galleries. Let's actually do this real quick. Yeah, well, if you look at the bottom of the screen down there, right about here, you'll see that URL in the yellow box. That is the URL to the playlist for this show. This is episode 49, and I did take a few breaks during certain events in life. So there is lots of information on how to edit the wiki there. I might have to take another quick bathroom break. Let's put the chat back up. And let's do that bathroom break. And we're back. Let's pop over to Galanda real quick. Hey, Layton. Add Layton to this list here. Hello, I hate. Or is that E8?
Is the season of Festivalt in Stormreach.
Alrighty, so what else do we have to do this morning? Go, Kobold! Hey! There we go. That works. Yep, very good with the screenshot thing. DDO screenshot, good. Good, good. Let's go to your talk page real quick. It looks like you've already had a welcome a long, long time ago. So let's check something real quick here. 113 months old with 4 edits. There we go. You now have DDWiki VIP, so you won't have to do the capture every time. It doesn't need the alt language stuff. It doesn't need this. There. Let's do a little bit of testing here. What happens if we make it a thumb? Or actually, we set this as... Alt. Make it a thumb. That doesn't work. Where did my menu bar go? No, that's fine. 300 by 400 is fine. Okay, it's... Hey, random DDO user, thanks for that. It's offline. Check again. Absolutely. Yeah, I don't like the way that looks. Could do a mode slicer? That might be interesting. Guess that doesn't work.
Really?
Woohoo! I like that slideshow thing, but it doesn't seem to work, so. So if you want to make sure that the more important part is actually the widths. Ah, 1.28 for slideshow, and we don't have that yet. Okay. No, it requires a higher level of MediaWiki than we have. We're at 1.23, and it looks like slideshow is only available for 1.28, so it'll be a while before we get there. It'll actually be two more updates, which will be a year or two. No difference, okay. Recent changes. Alrighty. We're down to the end here. We need three more people to say hi. So if you're lurking in chat there, you haven't said hi yet, go ahead and say hi today. 500 DDO points today will be our giveaway. That doesn't look good. I'll have to make some changes there. In Twitch chat. Say hi in Twitch chat here. Alright, so we have G-H-E-A-R. We have Dynasty 76088. We have Dante is already in the list. Alright, what else do we have? Good morning, Bach. Andrew. Leslie. Bach Lagore. Alrighty. The real Mav, okay. Thank you. What else do we have? Windows update. All right, so let's see here. Oh, I'm gonna need another cup of coffee and then I will do the drawing. I know that at least one person is in-game indicated that they are making a Twitch account so that they can enter. So I'm gonna give them a couple minutes while I make a cup of coffee. I'm gonna leave the mic on. No, and the screen up. Old people. Old people problems, getting up out of a chair. Don't ever get old, people. Don't ever get old. Don't ever stick your tongue in a light socket. I mean... I'm not worthy. So did everybody get a brand new $3,000 game machine for Christmas? Because if so, I missed out on the deal. And I'm sad. Everything was covered in a sheet of ice last night on the way home at 1 a.m. Well, that fixed the lag. Yes. Because there is very little actual game lag. Most of the lag is on the local PC of the person or in their internet connection. Finally worked. Excellent. Good morning, Ton. T-O-N. J-M-S-K. All right. Not after buying your kids' iPads? T-shirts for sale, no. No, just the expansion pack. You're not. There are some glitches. I'm without video, just chat. That's fine. I use IRC all the time and only have chat. Buzzing sound occasionally. Yes, I am aware of that. Everybody have new 8K monitors? Alright, so 10:07, that's close enough to 10 o'clock. We're going to do our drawing. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. In their Twitch inbox. Alrighty, let's do it. Save and roll for winner. Latency. It could be Buck. There you go. Excellent. Entrant number 21 out of 29. So, Thursday night on twitch.tv/lotrostream. I will be doing Shoe Streams, Lord of the Rings Online. And then I will be back next week on Tuesday. Make sure that you check out all of our other streamers on DDO Stream. There is a schedule up when the channel goes offline. There's also a Google Calendar for who's going to be online. This week, there may be a few gaps and who would normally be streaming due to holidays and people being away. I might actually fill in for a couple of the gaps this week. So stay tuned. Make sure that you're following the channel if you're not already. Make sure that you're following Bakla Gore's channel if you're not already. Follow my channel if you're not already. Follow Nerve's channel, who will be on next. He should be starting... Oh, when does he start his stream? Horrible at this. He starts his stream Tuesday... Oh, let's bring it up. Set as desktop background. Tuesday, 3 p.m. DDOPL at 3 p.m. Everybody have a great week, and I will see you next time around.